Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa urging President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to be man enough and tell him if the International Criminal Court investigators were allowed into the country. De La Rosa says it would feel as if the president backstabbed him if ICC investigators were allowed into the country without his knowledge. De La Rosa is reacting to statements of former Senator Antonio Trillanes that the ICC has concluded its probe into the Duterte administration's drug war. Trillanes claims the ICC is set to issue arrest warrants against relevant officials. The ICC prosecutor believes former President Rodrigo Duterte and his top officials encouraged the bloody drug war.
Kung mag-cooperate ang gobyerno natin, kahit na meron silang warrant of arrest, pumunta sila dito, sino mag-aristo? Diba, they need the cooperation of this government para ma-aristo yung subject na gusto nilang aristo.
The National Telecommunications Commission slaps an indefinite suspension order against controversial TV network SMNI. The NTC says it received reports the network is still operating in certain provinces in the country despite the 30-day suspension order issued by the commission last month. The network has also yet to explain why it should not be sanctioned over its alleged franchise violations. SMNI has been engaged in a legal battle for alleged violations in its franchise and spreading misinformation. The son of former President Rodrigo Duterte flagged over his district's hefty budget during his father's term. House Appropriations Committee Chairperson Elizalde Co claims Davao City 1st District Representative Paulo Duterte received a 51 billion peso budget from 2020 to 2022. Co says that amount is the highest fund allocated for a district in Philippine history.
So when I requested the Appropriations Committee and sa DPWH check the list, doon ko po ako nagulat. Unprecedented, sobra-sobra, especially for a developed country.
Cost investigation came after Duterte complained that the House leadership only allotted 500 million pesos for his district's projects this year. Duterte added the budget reduction could be due to his opposition to the People's Initiative for Charter Change. Co denies this.
Paano naman nabawasan ng 51 billion nga po yung na-receive niya on the last 3 years. So, ang problema naman, nagre-reklamo naman ho yung mga bagong congressman na unfair naman yan. Eventually, na-notice po namin yan on this second budget. And we already agreed sa department na sige na nga sabi namin, kayo nang bahala, pantay-pantay.
The Philippine Senate deviates from its original plan in reviewing the economic provisions of the 1987 Constitution. See, last week, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri said Senator Sonny Angara will lead a subcommittee for discussions on economic charter change. But after a closed-door meeting Monday, the resolution of both houses has been referred to the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments headed by Senator Robin Padilla. No details yet on the sudden change of plans. House Speaker Martin Romualdez firmly denies instigating a people's initiative to amend the Constitution. RG Cruz reports.
Various progressive groups, including the Makabayan Bloc, picketed the gates of the House on the first session day of 2024 to voice their opposition to charter change. But Speaker Martin Romualdez was unfazed as he welcomed the Senate's decision to join the House in amending the restrictive economic provisions of the charter to allow foreign investors into more sectors of the economy.
We therefore welcome the recent move of the Senate, led by the Honorable Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, in joining the House of its representatives in its historic and laudable efforts towards charter change via Constituent Assembly.
Former Speaker and Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez doesn't trust the charter change push now, warning it may be rushed and may go beyond the economic provisions. This even if Alvarez pushed for charter change under the Duterte administration as Speaker.
I cannot see the importance of changing the Constitution now. They say for economic reasons. Is it the people's interest? or somebody else's interest.
Retired Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio is uncomfortable that the People's Initiative to allow joint voting of senators and congressmen in charter amendments continues even after the Senate agreed to amend the charter.
Binibigay na ng Senado yung hinihingi ng House, pero yung House tuloy pa rin mag-collect ng signatures. Binabaliwala yung offer ng Senado. Kung talagang sincere sila na economic provisions lang, pwede naman diretso sa economic provisions para walang mag-suspect na iba yung motibo nila.
Carpio, who penned the Supreme Court ruling striking down the People's Initiative during the Arroyo administration, maintained that this mode of charter change cannot be used to remove checks and balances.
Pwede yan for amendment of the Constitution lang, yung simple amendment lang. Pero pag pinapalitan mo yung check and balance, like yung separate voting, tatanggalin mo, gawin mong joint para overwhelmed na ang Senate, baliwala na yung boto ng Senate, hindi pwede yan kasi that is a structural change.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa tags the speaker as the one behind the People's Initiative, citing unnamed House sources.
Yun ang sabi sa akin ng congressman eh. Yun ang sabi sa akin. Oh, hindi ko na sabihin kung sino. Ang dami ng mababait na congressman sa Mindanao na nagpapasintabi, tatawag sa'yo. Pasensya ka na, Sen, ha? Following orders lang kami, mga ganon, ganon.
But the speaker denied this.
Senator Bato talking, I don't know what he's talking about. He has not mentioned any comments. I don't respond.
De La Rosa claims those who signed in Davao received claim stubs worth certain sums of money.
Mga congressman, tanongin nyo kung sino congressman sa Davao, except Congressman Pulong and Congressman Ungap. Hindi sila kasama dyan.
Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva urges the public to report incidents of irregularities in signature buying. The Department of Interior and Local Government maintains nothing bars elected village officials from participating in the People's Initiative, contrary to statements attributed to DILG Undersecretary Felicito Valmosina. Former Congressman Alfredo Garbin already refuted Valmosina. The DILG explained that the Commission on Elections approved the recommendation not to prohibit elected village officials, but the agency warned them to just the same be careful till they are sure what they can and cannot do.
Ibig sabihin po pwede, but again, they cannot use government resources. No? Ganun po iyon, malinaw po iyan, maski saan. No? Pero po pwede. Po pwede po talaga yan. Let us proceed from this very carefully. As far as we are concerned, we wrote a letter.
Yung sigurong binabanggit, yung tinatawag na non-partisan nature ng barangay election. Election po yon at nakalagay po yon sa kaso ng Quintos versus Comelec na sinasabi ng Korte Suprema na kaya nga sila namumulitika. Therefore, political ang barangay SK election.
Election lawyer Romulo Macalintal urged the Comelec to stop accepting signature sheets till a petition is filed since the signatures cannot come before the initiative. But Comelec spokesperson John Rex Laudianco explained the signatures will be part of the petition that will be filed. Laudianco notes Comelec Resolution 10650 requires that the petition come with certifications that the required number of signatures have been met. The People's Initiative needs to gather the signatures of 3% of voters in each of the 254 congressional districts. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. orders the creation of an online portal looking to provide information for the public to better understand the El Niño phenomenon and its effects on various sectors. In the order, Marcos directed the Task Force El Niño and the Philippine ICT Department to mount the online platform. Among its features are interactive maps and visualizations, as well as data-driven plans and programs related to El Niño. The executive order did not include a timeline and deadline as to when the platform will be launched. But it notes the online platform will serve as a centralized repository of data, research, and information concerning El Niño. Now let's get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Good morning, Lori.
Good morning, ma'am, and to all our viewers and listeners. Right now, northeast monsoon is still affecting northern Luzon, and it's causing cloudy skies with rains over Cagayan Valley region. So, possibility of flash floods and landslides are still there due to moderate to at times heavy rains. while cloudy skies with light rains is still going to be experienced over Cordillera, Administrative Region, Aurora, and Quezon to Tomihan. Here in Metro Manila, Ilocos Region, the rest of Central Luzon, and the rest of Calabarzon, we will experience isolated light rains any time of the day due to Amihan, while the rest of the country, they will experience generally fair weather apart from localized thunderstorms. Right now, gale warning is still raised over the northern and eastern seaboards of northern Luzon as well as the western seaboard of northern Luzon. So sea travel is still risky for small seagrass. We're not advising small sea vessels to venture out into the sea because we will still be experiencing or we will still be expecting rough to very rough seas over northern Luzon. That's the latest from Pagasa. This is Lori De La Cruz.
Thank you very much for that update, Lori.